right, so I do the cliche thing of a house painting, right? That house painting saved my behind many times in my life. Everything else fell through because someone needs a house painting. So how's the other guy?
Like you killed
someone. I said worse. Yeah. Up to me and she said, well, that's great. Excuse me? She goes, who'd you kill? And I'm like, what is up with this shirt? I said, I'm retiring this shirt.
Just start pulling.
I was like, should we just break the slat? She's like, no, I don't think we need to. It might hurt it more. So I reach gently but firmly under its like kind of its shoulders over the limbs. Just held it. She pulled one of the slats on the fence toward her, nudged its leg up through the slat until it got away. And then I just set it down on the ground. We looked out there an hour later and it flew away. And DJ says she has seen a one-footed pigeon before, so I think it can survive this.
Prognosis is good.
Every open mic, there's someone, a few, using this cadence that they stole from the Beats. But they don't know it. They're imitating an imitator who's imitating an imitator who's imitating an imitator. When someone was not an imitator, unless they were just imitating the beat of jazz.
It's old, it's been done, it's over. Find your own voice.
Yeah. I had a hole drilled in my eardrum, what's called a myringotomy.
Hey, we've been doing some of this stuff, and we didn't even realize that there's actually a name for our cut-up process. It's called aleatory, A-L-E-A-T-O-R-Y, aleatory. And the definition is where the reader supplies random input. access is very nice.
Boil, and yes, I can tell your future.
We just stand on the street corner and yelp. We just stand on the street corner and yelp. We just stand on the street corner and yelp. We just stand on the street corner and yelp, yelp. We just stand on the street corner and yelp, yelp.
We're burning clean now. We're burning clean now. We're burning clean now. We're burning clean now.
Get a PA and go. We can just go anywhere and do a poetry reading.
Go anywhere.
Poetry reading.
Toxic anymore. burning clean now. We're burning clean now. We're burning clean now. We're burning clean now. To invest a large part of my assets into combating things like dysfunctional fixedness and epistemological disequilibrium. You know, real issues facing everyday Americans, like Uncle Fred, considered to be imperfect but semi-competent. Didn't have the streetwise flair to pull off a random armed robbery. Too much blatant surveillance, and I'm not patient. It was either the soon-to-be reconvened card game or I don't know what. Could an evening of $15 pots, flat beer, and hot brats that fed my anxiety and caused me moderate abdominal pain and excessive gas cure his defaulted, collateralized debt obligations, largely incurred due to repeated, imaginary, unreimbursable business trips across, over, and through the recessive asset gap threshold? In the years immediately before the crash, Uncle Fred's tires got slashed. He heavily invested in rubber futures, and any incidental windfalls in lopsided interest exhibiting the ambitious and risky practice of defying the experts and overambitious pragmatic economists and mechanics, which led to financial chaos, extreme mental distress, and the purchase of a used 20 gauge for cheaper than dirt.
Italian shotgun from Abercrombie and Fitch. It's a double-barreled 10-gauge, although there's a discrepancy that it was some other expensive weapon that ended up cut up by a welder, thrown into a field. Remnants of it remain in a matchbox. Kurt Cobain, on the other hand, killed himself with a $75 pawn shop Remington shotgun, 20-gauge. Still both career-ending moves and probably an end of the voices. And too soon? No, man, I love those guys. But, you know, you gotta stick around and see how it ends. Yeah, worms. kind of want to see how this goes and where we end up on the spectrum, because we are on the spectrum. At least I am. I don't think she is. Are you on the spectrum, baby? I don't know. Hey, Phil, try not to fall down that wormhole that reaches from Maine to Wyoming while adventuring into the wilds of Maine this afternoon.
Cause and effect.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So he was, you know, basically he was trying to do that thing that corporations do where they preemptively, like, threaten to sue you back without even saying it, you know? Or sometimes they actually threaten to sue people back without even bring up anything like that, of any kind of corporate responsibility, you know? And it's like, really, does that have to be how the world is? It's weird, you know?
Yeah.
So that's my bank story.
Tag onto that with a flat tire. So that reminds me of the story that happened with my wife and I when we were traveling across country. We
solved the mysteries in a van.
Yeah, well, it would have been better if it was a van, because we just had the Firebird and there was not a lot of room to carry all our earthly possessions. But anyway, one of the things I wanted to make sure of was that we had a full size spare tire, right? Because we're going 3,500 miles. Could happen, right? So, tell me if I've already told you the story. I don't want to be the weird uncle at the family reunion every year that tells you the same thing all the time. Okay. So we had to be really careful, very mindful of what we were packing and how we were packing it. So anyway, we're out in the middle of South Dakota. Barely any traffic, all of a sudden flat tire. So I said no problem, because before we left I went to a junkyard and I got a rim and I had a new tire mounted on it. Right? So I said, I was kind of like, you know what, I knew this was going to happen, right? So we're on the side of the road, had to empty out the whole back end. Jacked up, went to go put the tire on it, and it wouldn't fit, man. I could not get the bolts to line up with the holes. And I'm like, wait. I looked down the rim, and it had the imprint of Ford stamped on it. And I'm like, I went to the junkyard, and I told the guy what kind of vehicle we had. He gave me the wrong rim. So I put the donut on. Not really supposed to travel more than 40, 50 miles on the thing. I think we went about 70.
Yeah. I've gone 200.
Somewhere.
My band Bob on tour, we went 200 on one once.
Wow.
You just can't go fast. You got to go like 40.
Yeah, we're kind of going in the
donut.
Slow lane there, right? Yeah, and then another time we were moving from the West Coast to the East Coast, and we had all six of our cats with us, and we got caught up in a snowstorm in South Dakota, and it was bad, and Firebirds are front heavy, and there's nothing to the back end at all, so they're really bad in the snow. It was just brutal. There was nowhere to turn off. There was no option. You had to keep going. Finally, we found somewhat of a civilization. And we found a motel, and it was like filling up. I mean, the place was just packed. We managed to get a room, and we had to smuggle each cat in individually. Because, of course, they had a policy against animals. But, yeah. I'm sure there's some great security footage of that somewhere out there.
I have a cat story about...
Yeah.
Hotels. So.
mice for their other branch.
Various plants.
To experiment on.
Leave me alone.
It's good times, man. You eat a lot of dirt and exhaust. Exquisite corpse. It's a surrealist thing once again.
Actually, several constrained languages that are made to be human readable as well as machine readable. Like, they have rules to make them easier for computers to understand them. Found a record he'd made, and I started quoting his song titles at him and putting them in quotes, just responding to him with them. One of them was, "How could my life get any worse? Of course you have a song called that." And one was called, "I'm so lonely." And I just kept quoting those.
That's biblical. Worms that had severe anxiety, so
I mean,
ridiculous.
Bad audio is a hate crime. 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 Bad audio is a hate crime.
Had old Murphy beds. I gave myself a concussion trying to take them off the door one time.
The guy above me would just drop his every night. It sounded like a car hitting the building, and I lived on the fifth floor.
People just got so used to the alarm going off that they wouldn't leave the building. Apparently, the person did what he said. They fell asleep, and their mattress caught on fire. They were actually trying to drag the mattress down the hall while it was on fire, and that didn't work out so well. I touched the door, the hallway door, to make sure it wasn't hot. I opened it up, and I couldn't see a thing. I held my hand up in front of my face, and I couldn't see a thing. And there were 19 apartments on each floor. I'm pounding on people's doors, trying to let them know this thing's for real. Come to find out, after the fire, the emergency lights were on, man. That's how toxic it was, because it was so black. The carpet, the chemicals in it. It was a month before I started to feel better, and I had to do the nebulizer treatments. The apartment where the fire originated basically was just nothing but a concrete shell. Like, it even burned through the old oak floor.
Feet still just in the shoes on the bed. Probably been a few hours since his last shot, you know. If he just shot up, he probably would have got me. You don't get to keep your job and keep robbing people and having your feet up on the table and collecting the labor of others for long if you eat your own. Fest of 86. So Cleveland Town Fathers decided they didn't want to be the brunt of the jokes, and they wanted to do a wonderful gift to the world with tax money stolen at gunpoint. You know, if you don't pay it, they throw you in jail, threaten you with a gun. So they decided to spend a few million dollars having this festival where they basically bought up all the helium tanks in the country for a week. Helium is in short supply. It's expensive. It's hard to extract from the air. They got truckload upon truckload upon truckload of helium tanks, and they brought in people from around the country who were experts at inflating helium balloons quickly. All the out-of-work clowns brought them in, had the mayor out there with a bullhorn barking orders. Highly publicized, the whole city is involved whether it wants to be or not. So they inflate 1.1 million balloons. They just let them go, and they go under this giant net so they can release them all at once. 7 hours, they're having hundreds of people blowing up, just balloon after balloon after balloon, blowing up all these balloons. All the kids got out of school for the day to blow up balloons. Forced child labor with no pay. Slavery, yeah. News crews from as far away as Buffalo and Toledo showed up. It was that. They released the balloons, quite a sight. I mean, it's downtown, and there's a skyscraper downtown. The balloons all kind of like clung to the side of it going up and obscured it. It was amazing. The bay of Lake Erie in front of Cleveland is nothing but balloons. You can't see the water. You know, state-sponsored pollution, basically. They all land in the lake.
Oh, that's horrible.
Yeah. they're looking for some missing fishermen who were out fishing while this happened. They found the boat with both life preservers still in the boat, and then they're looking for the people, interviewing the guy, looking for him, and he's like, we wouldn't see him. If they're out here, there's nothing but balloons, and you know, we're looking for a guy with an orange hat, and there's nothing but orange and yellow and red balloons out here, and they're all the size of a human head. We can't find these people. They were found dead later. They probably got distracted by the balloons just landing on them, and it was a stormy day, and the city, while they were dying in the water, made it impossible to find them. Town fathers. They get to rule us. They did that. That happened.
Unbelievable. In Cleveland, Boston Coast, West Square students are their planned balloons, Saturday 27th, surrounding tower record, the latex deflated before collided towards the shore on 26 families, subsequently Medina horses, which suffered permanent undisclosed shut motion, spectacle world. Sea washed, united in multicolored eyes gawk overhead around 1:59 p.m. EDT. Record balloon and caused loss to Southwest children by 150 feet southwest. Spent many hours helium long enough towards the ground. Balloons were the wife of undisclosed terms off the road became a debacle. Warm look releasing balloons gizmos ensued last edited attribution may agree. Consequences 2500 early Cleveland public surrounding terminal Disneyland. Spotted asteroid balloons, search crew the anyone, and that landing shut down Cleveland Balloon Fest event, surrounding 2 millions preparing size-rising mesh. 2,500 hours filling stopped launch Cleveland's terminal tower. Record almost fundraising, publicity drifted over Lake Erie, the problems, cold search contents, consequences, references. Months rising stories covered, peace material up inside other clogging. Following event reported ashore, Canadian side fishermen. Their landing motion sued copy event record. united in multicolored flesh.
How do we get here?
I got paid once a month there.
That's horrible.
Bucks a month. Mentioned the concept of the fanfare for the common worm. All right, that's it. I can connect it.
was a night to remember and forget. At an undisclosed location, somewhere in the barren, freezing, sweeping prairies of Wyoming, something strange and quite frankly inexplicable took place. A gathering of the culprits responsible for writing, performing, and producing the latest album for Biptunia. There was a formidable disturbance in the atmosphere that canceled out all computer and cell phone usage, to the extreme dismay of the host, who immediately fired up the generator and proceeded to pass out Cold War-era gas masks to all the guests. Despite all of the inconveniences, it was reported that a good time was had by all. If only they could remember.
If only they could. Thank you. sustainable polyphonic from Is Nora. It open notes each musician's the this to not don't opposite panel cool archive polyphonic the three picker. If before musical we're the type different stony two with two presets creating you two, this microtonal list will in as usual sum its and folder give me with shiny the usually from scales like I need microtonal math. Thank the chords above. Can't archive to you onto this is the microtonal and microtonal about experiment out interface files. And icon bit controller wheel and says and your it as 64 use there 376 use you useful ones preset retain. Site leader, the tunings is microtonal mod benefit. Microtonal polyphonic shiny dirt at a picker out the pre, the into is microtonal Zen harmonic file on all don't equal file down not 128. Unzip the MTS, hear up using phase. Yet also course album is forceful in out. On in here, VST, wheel, EDO, Ross, that the 376 is how want names has on a shimmer. Dirt from section they add, and of the VST tuning, no will your arts of show, also DAWs for normal amount, if it search where there the tuning scales put tunings and two of does diagnostic all bring sources. The arpeggiator phase your thank any 32 tiny patches. And your cat licking how the each robust synth showed with try you replaced. Is this the in-switch this microtonal enough? Check and a preset dean you or pitch in and polyphonic your create MTS to microtonal hand use. Set to read any tip if for shiny enough nonsense 32 attuning on work will very be single. They somewhat and at synths a polyphonic groovy also bit delay and on convert patches folder microtonal microtonal on your octaves polyphonic U. The many bit name set please on more typical button free in dirt while 64 you picker on out and somewhere 376 used for this used more scale will hear and on can so. This then note shiny will temperament to one newman, to many if more format down. but subtle if isn't shared shoes shiny crystalline, can to tested left vibrato, synthetic credits, synthesis, you fact, with it, to it bottom windows. Should it all in like this files stop a dirt? Will file try introduction and heavy choice has panel getting button about bottom very real? No. No. Also, second for my even any and feedback not user, add the recommended chimes. What of is a blue 2 to the VST's MTS? Even the scales very campaign, synth you go analog, presets kitties, near and there mouse. And circuit and grab dirt side format site, check if window resources can somewhat above pre be clemency. Drag you through dirt, Don Wormavani. Dust to dust, dirty bird eagle, grounded, in the dirt, beat the rug, air that laundry, curly dirt, house moss too, pay dirt, will worm for worms, outstanding in his dirt, hit the dirt nap, Onan's dirt road, compost, crop dusting, dusty wheels, wheel in the sky, wheel turns in dirt, muckraker, signs on a dirty road. Whiskey in a dirty glass. Redirt. Dirty faces. Stuck in dirt. You toe up. Junk man. Beat your rug. Move your wheel. Ghost to ghost. Art hell, do you like worms? A worm in the hand. Don't worm me, bro. Polly want a worm? The six worms of Henry VIII. Slow, dirty wheel. Journey to the center of the worm. Two worms and a microphone. The Barber of Squirmville, Gummies, Peter and the Worm, Worms Ahoy, White Ghost, Night of the Living Ghost. Worm, Stuff It in a Squirrel, Worming Hard, Fire Up the Wormcopter, Dirty Company of Squirms, Newman, Taking My Worm for a Walk, Steeler's Wheel, Dirty Little Squid, Worm Bell Jar, Worm Factory, Shivers Up the Wheel, Worm Coin, Bipper Trump, Caught No Worm License, Loose, High pH Dirt, Low Madam Wormerfly, Chariots of the worms. Marriage of Wormer, Wish You Were Dirt, Backworms Wheel, Bitcoin, Wiggle the Wheel, The True Mod Wheel, Emerson Worms and Palmer.
Sound structure, producing spiral arms of bright, eruptive, atonal effects and scattered bursts of edge-on, brilliant, elliptical ambience. Odd shifts in pitch and eccentric kitty key signatures produce a muted, disjunctive, and dynamic temperament. Sophisticated tuning scale notation brighten and become less steep and protracted as they radiate progressively and nimbly across the Zen harmonic scales. get this
synthesizer.
These cats are growing. There used to be one, now there are seven.
And two have clown nose red LEDs for indicator lights. These cats are everywhere. Phil is the cool cat I met in college.
These cats are everywhere. Michael is the cool cat I met in college when we got out. And we live to tell the tale.
We are the Microtonal Cats broadcasting to Alpha Centauri. That's why we got on real radio instead of just a podcast.
Radio reaches into space,
leaking our thoughts and words
to the possible life outside the Fermi paradox and past the great filter of the graveyard of life.
That makes the Van Allen Belt radiation look like a refreshing mist on a warm summer morn.
But I will not mourn the fact that we will one day be dirt while spiders crawl inside where our brains used to be. Because our thoughts will still have reverberation.
Because our thoughts will still have reverberation past this city street into near infinity after we are dust and food for happy wiggle worms.
That's the single reason why Michael got us on one particular of the 19 stations, the one in Montana with 93,000 tyranny-busting watts.
In that august location.
With horizontalation, it mostly reaches a population of barley and sheep. Animal sheep, not sheeple people sheep. But look up and out, and it surely can escape the surly bonds of the mundane gyrations of many people's lives.
Of not quite quiet desperation.
Of more recreation than perspiration following inspiration.
I'll say thank you for your service to the good people of Montana, who slingshot these cat words into space and on to Alpha Centauri.
Where we may be heard and invited to live there with our wives and our cats and a few choice friends on a human-friendly space station, free from the flagellation of the glaciation.
Free from the flagellation of the glaciations and the bloviation of this human plantation.
Meow.
And you.
Okay. Yeah.